on your tablets, iPads or whatever, you'll be able to follow that on aiba.org as well with full pictures and commentary. We move on into the 56 kilogram division, the men's bantamweight semi-finals coming up next. And it's Murujon Akmadaliyev, the Uzbek boxer, up against Shiva Thapa, quality Indian boxer inside the top 10. He's rated 7. Akmadaliyev, who's caused a bit of a surprise so far. He beat the Kazakh number one seed Yeraliyev in the second round, and number 5 world-ranked Chachai Bhutdi in the previous round as well. So Akmadaliyev's got plenty of ability. Thapa, David, scored one of the highlight knockouts of the championship so far with a wonderful left hook earlier on in the competition.
Yeah, it was a fantastic shot, and he's in the opposite corner as my favourite boxer of all the little men, Akmadaliyev. Absolutely fantastic to watch. As long as he's got the right opponent in front of him, I think hopefully Thapa will be the opponent whose style will gel.
And the 2015 Asian Confederation silver medalist representing Uzbekistan, Murujon Akmadaliyev.
What a fantastic championship it's been so far for the Uzbekistan team. They came here with 9 boxers, 6 of them through to the semi-finals. A fantastic return, and you're going to see some quality operators from that country throughout the evening.
Great return, 6 out of 9.
First thing you notice is how much taller and rangier Thapa is compared to Akmadaliyev.
Seeing Akmadaliyev is really aggressive, come forward, puncher. See that left hand landing there, Thapa. He'll have to be switched on throughout this one.
You can see Thapa would prefer to box in range. Akmadaliyev wants things up close where he's powerful, throws strong shots and throws plenty of them.
Good way from Thapa there, landing 3 clean shots on Akmadaliyev. He's getting his shots off early in this one.
And this is a rerun of the Asia Confederation Championship bouts. Akmadaliyev got the silver medal in that one, bronze for Thapa. Akmadaliyev beat Thapa to get to the final.
Some good shots being landed already. A good short right hook there from Akmadaliyev, and then a counter right hand from Thapa himself. So this is warming up nicely. Right.
Jamie Conlon, Michael Conlon, I should say. His brother Jamie's birthday today. More on that later. He's in the other half of the draw. He's in the other semi-final. He actually beat Thapa in the Commonwealth Games in the very first round last summer in Glasgow. Quite a few of these know each other very, very well in this division.
Yeah, there's so many great opportunities to compete in tournaments these days. They're bound to come across each other once or twice.
And Akmadaliyev has really carried his strength up through the divisions. He started winning national youth and junior tournaments at light flying, since progressed all the way up to bantam, and he's won a couple of national titles back home in his native Uzbekistan. Now he is up here at 56 kg.
He's absolutely thrown himself into that left hand as Thapa is moving away, and he's fallen over his front foot as a result, and Thapa could take advantage of that.
Big left hand there from Thapa. That was the punch that did for Hamu in the earlier round, the second round.
It's good boxing from Thapa, using his feet. And Akmadaliyev just needs to keep his feet under him because he's fallen over his front foot on the way in.
He's so determined to put pressure on Tapper. He's slightly neglecting some of his boxing here. Flurry of punches from Akhmed Aliyev. There was a beautiful counter in there from Tapper again with that measured left hook. Wonder how the judges saw that first one.
Depends what the judges prefer.
Akhmed Aliyev gets the round on all three of their scorecards. And there were some nice punches landed by Tapper in that one.
Yeah, Tapper was moving well, using his feet to get out of range, and couple of times he turned Akhmed Aliyev when he had his back to the ropes and made Akhmed Aliyev miss wildly. So he's boxing well, it's just that the judges seem to prefer the pressure and the come forward style of Akhmed Aliyev.
Tapper, the only Indian boxer of a six-man team that came to the championship still left in. He's going to need a couple of big rounds if he's to remain the last man standing.
Round two.
It looks as though Tapp has decided that he's going to have to throw it all in.
Yeah, it looks that way. And I don't know whether that's the best idea. We've seen Akhmed Aliyev against someone willing to do that in his first contest, and he looked absolutely destructive. Tapper had success using the feet in the first round, and I think he should stick to those tactics. He's fighting Akhmed Aliyev's fight.
Both landing big punches in that little flurry. And there is plenty of sort of warning of the boxers to keep their heads up. That's very much part of the new AIBA Heads Up campaign. With head guards no longer in operation, we're going to create a culture whereby boxers are boxing as safely as they possibly can, and cuts are reduced by as much as they can.
Yeah, it is a hazard, a potential cut in a tournament where you'd have to box more than three times most of the time in a week. Shot by Tapper, two right hands landed there.
And again.
Great work from the Indian boxer. And he used his feet to get out of range again. He seems to have booked his ideas up in this second half tactically.
Again, the pressure coming from Akhmed Aliyev. Does he have Tapper's number? He says he did earlier on this year.
It's easier said than done, but I think for Tapper, a jab and then one step back, and as Akhmed Aliyev's advancing, he can land the right hand and seems happy to stand and trade a little bit more in this round.
Yeah, he's tried both options in the first two rounds. He did have success at the early part, but I think some of those right hands were working well for him. Relentless pressure from Akhmed Aliyev, not taking a back step so far in this bout. Well, some of the eye-catching punches at the start of the round came from Tapper, but all the pressure was coming from Akhmed Aliyev.
Yeah, I'd say that's about fair, although they are close rounds, but the judges have got to pick a winner. You can't score it an even round, and for me, I'd have gone with Akhmed Aliyev because Tapper decided to engage in Ahmed Elyev's fight.
So, Ahmed Elyev very much in control of his own destiny here. Tapa might need that big left hook again. Oh, here we go.
Fantastic action.
This is what it means to be in a World Championship semi-final with gold or silver staring you in the face. Some of the tape around the glove of Ahmed Elyev coming loose. What a shame.
I think they'll just start off where they've just left off, because there's so much at stake now in this last round. The place in the Olympics and obviously the place in the final. Got a hand it to Tapper though. He's willing to fight any way possible to get the victory, but Ahmed Elyev just seems to have a tiny bit more, but there's not much in it.
Tapper's come out this round as if he knows he's behind and he needs something special.
Yes, he's got a great right hand.
Massive right hand from Tapper. Can he pull something special out of the bag, the Indian?
It was a fantastic shot, but Ahmed Elyev took it brilliantly and fired back as soon as he found his foot again.
And here goes Tapper again. He's got a minute and a half to find a minor miracle. Maybe an eight count could turn things around for him.
Tapper seems the fresher of the two, Alex, to me. Unless, you know, he knows he's behind, he's willing to do more, but he said Ahmed Elyev's been involved in some real wars already this week.
And Tapper, with a minute to go, has already produced a knockout this week.
So he's done less rounds.
There's another big right hand. Two in a row from Tapper. He's starting to unleash the heavy guns.
Good round for Tapper.
I must admit, I thought boxing would be the way for Tapper, that perhaps he could use his sort of height and reach. But he's gritting his teeth, he's just throwing leather, and that's working for him.
Fantastic work again from both boxers in the centre of the ring. Both just literally throwing everything they've got, putting their heads down, throwing as many punches as possible in the hope one lands, but
it's been a terrific effort from Tapper this round.
It really has.
Is it too little too late? Closing seconds of the third. Another big right hand from Tapper.
Great round for Tapper for me this.
The Indian has thrown everything into this. He couldn't have done any more this round.
The most clear-cut round of the contest for me. And he's not going to win the fight though, because of the first two rounds. But they think he's done enough in the corner.
Excellent effort from Tapper, but with that first two round success, Ahmed Elyev just too far clear to be caught.
And that is the final of the winner on points from the red corner, representing Uzbekistan.
Some boos from the crowd behind us, but Ahmed Elyev, having been awarded the first couple of rounds on work, ethic, effort and aggression, is the first Uzbekistan boxer from a successful group of players to reach a World Championship final at these championships. What a moment for him. confirmation of the scorecards, and the tappers for working the final round was indeed rewarded.
Oh, it was a great round for Tapper, and I quite liked Tapper in the first round when he was boxing using his feet, only obviously the judges preferred the aggression.